Wild cougar approaches a mom's young daughter before she's forced to act fast. Most parents would do anything to protect their children. There have even been crazy cases of mothers exhibiting superhuman strength to save their babies, like lifting the weight of an entire car off their infant, or chasing a rolling shopping cart with impossible speed. And one Canadian woman was faced with a terrible scenario when a wild cougar came for her young daughter. Feeling that motherhood superpower energize her, she leapt into action right as the cougar closed in on her child. Squamish, a town in British Columbia north of Vancouver, is generally a peaceful place. This is where Pablo Espinosa and his wife Maureen Lee, seen, and their daughter Maya, below, all live together. The family loved a local area called Fisherman's Park, not far from the Squamish River. It's a place where anyone can enjoy scenic views, relaxing strolls, and of course, fishing. This is where Maureen Lee and her daughter Maya decided to spend their bright and sunny Saturday. The pair was enjoying the warm water, picking berries from the many trees, when Maureen noticed a particularly juicy-looking fruit and turned around to pluck it. That's when she saw it, something strange out of the corner of her eye. At first, she couldn't make out exactly what it was. A dog, perhaps? But then, she turned around. The mother spotted any parent's worst nightmare. She hadn't seen a dog, rather. It was a wild cougar. And it was in the midst of attacking her three-year-old daughter. All of a sudden, it just flew on her, rolled her a couple of times, and grabbed her under its belly, on the ground, like in the fetal position. She was on her back, and he had his paws in her head, the mother recalled. In such a terrifying situation, Maureen had no idea what to do, but in a split second, that felt like an hour, an idea, no, an instinct, popped into her mind. She acted on it. I just knew I had to react quick, so I just jumped in there and wedged myself between the cougar and her on the ground, and I got up and threw it off my back and grabbed her and booked it, she said. But this was far from the end of their story. Thankfully, the little girl escaped without any serious wounds, but she wasn't entirely unscathed. Maya did have puncture marks from the animal's claws on her left arm and head. The toddler had some interesting remarks to make after the attack. According to neighbor Wade Rowland, Maya simply didn't understand that the feline wasn't an animal to be messed with. She was confused as to why the creature wouldn't, in her words, play nice. Unfortunately, that wasn't the only close encounter with a cougar by residents in the area. In fact, there have been a total of 30 within only a 10-day period, and one Friday was particularly bad. On this particular day, there were 6 attacks in a 24-hour period. Officials knew this data wasn't adding up to the full picture. These animals are usually peaceful when it came to their interactions with humans. See, in North America, fatalities resulting from wild cougar attacks are extremely rare. You are more likely to be killed by a lightning strike, snake bite, or even a bee sting. So why were these felines so bloodthirsty? Determined to find the answers, a team of 5 conservation officers, along with 2 dogs, were sent on a mission to track down the animals in question and figure out why exactly they'd been motivated to hurt the young girl. After following the cougar through a few yards, they caught up to her. The feline couldn't be wrangled, though, and the team was forced to take her out permanently. The question still remained: why had she committed the crime in the first place? After tracking down additional cougars, local officials landed on 2 different reasons for the brutal attacks. And each conclusion accounted for all the local assaults, not merely the one perpetrated on 3-year-old Maya Espinosa. One of the cougars the animal experts found was clearly starving, as it had been found emaciated. The creature had been desperate to find something to eat. As for the other? The second cougar killed by authorities had assaulted a human being simply because it was young and a naive baby, making its first attempts at learning how to hunt. The events transpiring were tragic on all accounts. Friends worried Maya wouldn't be the same. "She's very lucky," commented local official Dave Ritchie. "Hopefully she'll be surviving and not be too traumatized by it. But it would be a traumatic event for parents and a young child." However, remarks from the girl herself may suggest she's not traumatized in the least. Maya's father, Pablo Espinosa, reported that the preschooler didn't actually seem perturbed by the incident at all. In fact, she was excited to return to school to tell all her little friends about the crazy incident. She never suspected her friends could have similar stories.